Hello, my name is Bone Rivers, and I am the style critic for Charlie's Quarantine Corner. Today is an exciting day, and it is an unbelievably stylish event here at the red carpet. Oh, Professor Wizard! Oh, it's so good to see him. He looks fantastic. That pointy hat, it's nice and pointy like a dunce cap, and he's got that rope around his waist. It's very gold and purple, a very regal colors. So I think he looks, oh, so wonderful, so wonderful. All right, and Mr. Ice Cream. Hello, Mr. Ice Cream. He looks great. He looks very creamy and very Neapolitan, if I may say so myself. He looks very good. I think the stripes don't really help him, but at the same time, he's being bold. He's going out there. He's saying, I don't give a f- if horizontal stripes aren't really in. I'm still going to rock them, you know? So he looks okay. I don't have a problem with it. And oh, Mr. and Mrs. Cool. Oh, they look very cool, being real cool. They got that Kanye West no smile kind of thing going on. I love it. You can't even believe how much I love to see a good overall. And this is Orville, the little dog, and he looks so good with his overalls. Orville, can we get a picture? Can you turn around and pose for the camera? Oh, he looks so good. Look at a good little boy. Just because he happens to be my nephew does not mean that I'm biased to what a style icon this little boy is gonna be. But good boy, good dog. I love that little guy. Okay, next up we have, the star of the movie, Joker. He looks fantastic. He's got white, he's got yellow, there's diamonds, it's got everything. Joker. A funny man is a way to my heart, you know, that you can mount me. We'll get stuck together. You ever see two dogs get stuck together? It's very traumatizing for everyone involved.
So this is Bone Rivers reporting live from the red carpet. I think we should have this as a regular show, Patrick. Just, you know, Bone Rivers on the red carpet. They haven't said that about me since I dated Julianne Moore.
The lovely Regina Upright, who was a recommended guest from my good friend George Cox. Regina, thank you for being here.
Hey, girl, what's going on? It's good to see you. You know, I was Miss Apple Blossom 1979.
Ooh, I actually was not aware. I think we should start this interview with a cyber cheers. Ready?
Okay, cheers to you, honey. Yes, indeed. click. Okay, here we go. Dom Perignon.
How are you getting ready to celebrate Pride in a pandemic? Are you nervous about it? Do you have anything prepared?
Well, you know, I celebrate Pride every day because I came out back in 1979. And back then, it really wasn't so popular to come out in New Hampshire. And it really took me a long time just for my friends and family to accept me. And, you know, bless her heart, my mom, she died at 90. I'm the one who took care of her in the end. It was a blessing. Why just do it June? You should celebrate your pride every day. You really should.
Could not agree more. Have you ever considered doing YouTube tutorials, like makeup tutorials?
You know, I really should. And I use this great moisturizer. I don't know if you've ever seen this or not. It's really good on your face. It's Vaseline, and you just put it on your face, and it just makes you nice and smooth. Look at that. Glowing like a rock star. Yes, honey, Vaseline. Always keep it handy next to you. It really takes a lot to put this face together just to
face. What you're looking here, right here, this took 2 hours and 87 minutes. This is
Oh, I know, honey. You know, it's really, pain is beauty and beauty is pain.
It's true. That's what my mother's lover always said. I don't even know what else to talk about. I just really wanted to see you and say hi. What are you drinking? You said you're drinking Dom Perignon.
I'm drinking Dom Perignon. That's the knockoff version from Trader Joe's. It's delicious.
Oh, but, I am actually drinking ginger ale.
You know, I think we should just celebrate Pride Month, like I said, every day. And, you know, it is really a tough time right now. And I really hope it all just blows over and Trump...
Regina, goodness, we keep it nonpartisan here on Charlie's
Okay,
Quarantine
okay, yeah.
Corner.
Bless his heart.
See, so you live in New Hampshire, where George Cox also lives. Do you have opinions on having the state open? So what seems maybe a little sooner than a lot of people expected?
You know, I know George isn't doing any gigs, and who wants to do karaoke with a face mask? I mean, one person on stage and they're singing with a face mask. Do you really want to sing with a face mask?
Yeah, you know? I don't know. I it's interesting because I get that people are really eager to get out there and have fun. But I think that it's been this long that we've all been really responsible. So I feel like maybe keeping up the good work isn't a terrible idea. Have you done any virtual karaoke or has George done any events?
I have. But it's just like, it's so funny because when you try to do the virtual karaoke, it just lags behind. So people are trying to sing and I just couldn't get it to sync up. So, you know, yeah. we need a technical director. Maybe you, Charlie.
I definitely do want you to come be you or George to come and be a part of the open mic series. I'm really eager to get that.
When do you think things are going to be back to normal? Not for a long, not till we get a vaccine.
But I think we're in for this for a bit. And I think that making the best of it with, like, you know, with whether it be a radio show or a podcast or whatever, you know, like there's so many people. I'm such an in-person person and it's been so hard translating that to my computer, like a little green dot. It's just really difficult. But I think the more people like yourself who are artists that can kind of push through will make a big difference for people who need to be cheered up in all of this.
Yeah, no, I love doing my radio show and I even listen to it because I love all the songs and my husband and I always like, we'll have it on the porch, you know, so I'll have to do a shout out for you next one I do. But yeah, when you're creative, it's really tough for people who are doing it full-time performers, full-time DJs. They're all out of work.
I feel very blessed to have a job in public access, just to have a day job alone that I can do from home and whatever else. And just, I mean, calling it out, it is, you know, public access is kind of under attack right now from federal funding and cable, the cable.
It's really scary, but yeah. We're needed too. We're needed for the meetings.
It's so important. It's so important. And it's just so frustrating trying to explain it to people who just, it's like explaining to wear a mask to somebody that doesn't believe it. You know what I mean?
Well, people are watching Peg Access more than ever now. They are because you know, they can't go to the meetings or the town meetings in person now. So everybody's watching it more. And then we start doing the games virtually, a lot more people will be watching it. So I think it's very needed.
I'm not sure if you know, but I actually plan on hosting a weekly open mic all during Pride Month. So if you are available any Friday night, I would love to invite you to be my guest.
Sure. You know, my good friend George Cox is a DJ and he has a show called Disco Ball 2000 on 105.1 up here in Bedford. I'm sure we can get him to play a couple of numbers for you.
Oh my, if you could put a good word in with George, that would be so amazing.
I will. We're very close.
Oh, I have you two had a thing go? You know what? That's your personal business. I'll leave that to you. Regina Upright, it has been so lovely talking to you. And let's cheers one more time.
Woo. Kisses, honey, kisses. And we hope to be with you soon.
Yes.
Keep singing, keep entertaining, and we'll see you again next time.
Yes, you and I will be trolling for together in no time.
Cheers to that.
Hello and welcome to CQC News. A U.S. Postal Service worker is lifting the spirits of high school graduates along his route of Concord, New Hampshire. When Josh Crawwell saw 2020 grad signs on residents' lawns, he decided to give the graduates a handwritten note from mailman Josh, along with a $5 gift card to Dunkin' Donuts. These high school students have gone through their 12 years of school. They deserve a graduation, but unfortunately, they can't have one right now, Crawwell told the Concord Monitor. I just thought, what's something I could do to give them some recognition? Since delivering the cards, Crawwell has received notes and words of gratitude for his actions. One thank you note read in part, "This year has not been easy for most, but I think being able to make someone's day is important. Thank you for being an essential worker. It means a lot." Torrance Burson of Memphis, Tennessee, jumped into action after seeing his daughter Gabrielle Pierce upset because she had earned a degree from Xavier University in Louisiana, but would not be able to walk across a stage and receive her hard-earned diploma. So he decided to throw her a graduation at home. Burson went all out. The graduation included a stage that he built himself, presenters, speakers, and neighbors watching from the street. "I went to bed and woke up in the middle of the night and said, that's it, I'm just gonna do the graduation here," he said in a statement. Pierce said, "I was just in awe. I was amazed. I couldn't believe a lot of people showed up. People were driving by and yelling congratulations." So much time spent at home has people finding all sorts of ways to become creative, including taking out the trash. In Spain, for one three-year-old girl and her dad, Jaime, dressing up as different characters is a favorite part of their day. Since they only go outside to take out the trash, they've turned it into an opportunity to have some fun with costumes they have around the house. Apparently, getting dolled up to take out the trash has become a bit of a trend during quarantine time. Danielle Askew of Queensland, Australia, created the Facebook group Bin Isolation Outing, where people can share pics of their chic quarantine looks. Started on March 27th, the group already has over 1 million members. Basically, the bin goes out more than we do, so let's dress up for the occasion. The group's description reads, "Fancy dress up, makeup, tutu, be creative. Post photos to cheer us up. After all, laughter is the best medicine." And we now return you to your regularly scheduled programming.
Up next on Charlie's Quarantine Corner, Charlie puts the spotlight on someone she loves in this week's InterZoom. Get it? Like an interview, but over Zoom? Sort of a play on words. You know, just forget it. Just play the clip.
How have you been? I miss you.
It's better now that it's gotten warmer.
Yes.
I mean, it was pretty shitty when it was cold and rainy and being trapped indoors.
Have you been able to get out and get any exercise with the dogs and getting them running and stuff?
I've been playing a little bit of disc golf, but I haven't taken Titus back out on the course yet because I'm a little bit nervous about, like, I don't know how safe it is to have somebody pet my dog. And
yeah.
Pet my dog. I think it should be okay.
I saw recently that you were talking to the kids, was it from Bagley?
Yeah, that was really cool, Charlie, because what happened was I've been sitting here connecting with work through Zoom, and it got me to thinking, what about all of these LGBTQ youth that are in all these youth organizations and all these marginalized kids that maybe the only safe place they have is at Bagley or Camp Aeronautic or one of these places? And I wanted to find out what was going on, so I reached out to Grace Sterling Stoll, who is the director of Bagley. And then she organized it through her program director, Erin, for us to do an interview with their youth leaders. And they are doing some pretty amazing things. It's like, oh, I need to up my game now based on just what these kids are doing.
That's awesome. That's so cool. I think one of the first things that kind of clicked for me when the quarantine started was that there were going to be a lot of youth, but even just people in general that were going to be kind of like trapped in their houses. And some of the environments like may not be at all welcoming to their true identity and their true genders. And just, you know, I want to figure out more things that I can do too. I'm so inspired by you doing that because I really think that's really important right now.
They inspired me, so I'm glad it's contagious. They're raising money to go help these kids that all of a sudden have no health care because their families lost their jobs, so they've lost. I mean, I couldn't imagine what it would be like to be a youth that might be in mid-transition or an adult, like you said, that all of a sudden you lose your health care and now you're like, I've got to pay out of pocket for all of this. And these kids are like filling in that void during this through fundraising. And I'm like, okay, we're going to be okay with this. We are.
Was the GSA at Wellesley separate from the Bagley?
Yes, it was. The GSA I attended to was a middle school, and that was a totally separate thing. That was just a connection from the past reaching out to me and saying, hey, our GSA group wants you to come say hi to us because we miss you. So that was a connection from the past. And then while I was talking with them, I tried to get them to come and do an episode, and they were like, no, we're not that comfortable with it. But the meeting that I went to, Charlie, there were 16 participants.
Oh, wow.
One middle school, 16 participants. And it was, they ended up deciding what type of fruit would you be, like, based on the letter that you are. Like, if you're a lesbian, what would you be? If you were a gay man, if you were bisexual, transgender, Q, like, and they just decided that, I don't remember what fruit I was, but they gave me a fruit.
I think I would be a kumquat. I'm pretty sure that's what I would be.
Just because you like saying it.
Yes, that's exactly why. I don't even know. I couldn't pick a kumquat out of a lineup, but I love to say it. It's both parts of that word are just like yummy in my belly. I've been trying to stay off social media in the pandemic, but it's so hard because it's just like one of the only ways to really interact with people anymore.
But I joined a group yesterday called a group that is super f-ing nice for no reason. And I just wanted to do it just to like, that's like the title of the group. I'm like, oh, you know, this is like for like good news and cheering me up. It was all transgender kids that were like, I'm Kelly, all transgender kids that were just like, my dad just disowned me. Now I'm stuck at home. Like I have nowhere to wear my real clothes and all that. And I was just like, oh my God. And so I was like up till 2 a.m, like answering these kids, like, it's okay. Like it's gonna be okay. So I think there are definitely, and I'll invite you to the group now that I'm saying out loud, I'll invite you to get out of the room because I think you'd love it. But it's really important right now to kind of, at least, you know, I think for you and myself, like people who are adults who know what it's like to deal with all this stuff, to just try to help the kids stay connected and stuff, and everybody.
It's big. I mean, I just happened to make a post on Facebook. And a friend of mine that I've known since 1990, probably something like that, private messaged me and just said, hey, I'm inspired by what you're doing. And oh, by the way, my child just came out to me.
Oh, wow.
Right. And so you just never know the communities that like, there's so much the crossover between like, this is a disc golf community friend of mine who is a good person, but you know, we're disc golfers. That's how I know this person. And now all of a sudden we're on this whole nother level of connection that's like, okay, it just needs to happen. We just need to keep talking.
It's funny too. I feel like yourself and it's something that's I've experienced too. It's really humbling when somebody comes to you and they're like, you're like one of the only people I know that's part of this community. And now I know another person and I need some advice. I love being an expert on gender, but like, you're my expert. Cause like, I'm so much less, like, I don't know what to tell people. I'm just like, I'm me, shut up, leave me alone. Like, I don't know.
I'm starting to learn from you in that sense though. I think you might have, sometimes the way you approach it is the smart way to approach it too. It's just like, here I am, I'm gonna be me and it's gonna make you uncomfortable and it's probably going to be awkward a couple of times, but what else can we do? I can't ever not be me anymore. I pretended to be somebody else for so long that I can't not be me.
I think for me too, becoming friends with you, Pat, and just like the support of Pat's family and different people that I've gotten to know, it's been a cool transition for me to go, like I came out as transgender and then I started presenting like masculine, not like a man necessarily, but masculine. And like, that's not who I am all the time. Like I like to do drag. I like to sometimes like have a wig on or whatever. And I'm starting to be able to kind of just be like very comfortable with it. Like you said, just being like existing as I want to exist and whatever I can call myself any label I want. That's what I am to me. You're a goddess and you're full of light and love. And thank you so much for talking to me,
Carly. I appreciate this. I've been wanting to be a part of your show forever.
Oh, yay. I'm so glad. You're such a badass. I love you. I'll see you later.
Love you. Talk to you later. Bye.
No matter how hard I try, you keep pushing me aside and I can't break through. There's no talking to you.
It's so sad that you leave it. It takes time to believe it. But after all is said and done, you're gonna be the lonely one. Oh, do you believe? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough, no. Do you believe in love as a flow? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough, no.
What am I supposed to do? Sit around and wait for you. Well, I can't do that. and there's no turning back. I need time to move on. I need love to feel strong. 'Cause I've had time to think it through. And maybe I'm too good for you. Oh, do you believe in love after love? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough. No, do you believe in love after love? I can Well, I know that I'll get through this. 'Cause I know that I'm strong. I don't need you anymore. I don't need you anymore. I don't need you anymore. Said I don't need you anymore. Do you believe? I can feel something inside me say, I really don't think you're strong enough, no. Do you, how many times is it? It's a very repetitive chorus, woo! But I love to dance. You believe my song is, goodness.
And now a special CQC extra second installment of InterZoom. Get it? Like it rhymes with interview, but it's a Zoom call, right? So, you know, forget it. Just bring on State Rep Gouveia.
So you, it's nice to have you on Zoom. We actually met in person one time before at the Trans Day of Remembrance. So I'm really,
yes, I remember.
I'm so happy to have you on my Pride, my first Pride episode of Charlie's Quarantine Corner. Do you have any message for the trans, queer, LGBTQ community in the area?
Absolutely. Couple of things. My son is transgender, and he was starting his first year of college this year and had to bring him back in the middle of COVID and had a lot of challenges coming back with being misgendered. I know that flying for a lot of our transgender family and friends and loved ones and neighbors can be incredibly challenging when it comes to being misgendered. So that created a lot of challenges for him just coming back in the middle of COVID. And, you know, he's been getting some support and resources since he's been back in Acton and really making good use of some groups through the Triangle program and getting a lot of really solid gender affirming support. And so I would encourage anybody who's transgender or part of the LGBTQ community to certainly reach out. There are so many important resources and opportunities to engage in groups via Zoom, online. They have a lot of really solid programming that's really been, I think, of a lot of benefit and value. He is a young adult, so he's in a very different category than those who are part of the LGBTQ community who are teens. I'm not exactly as tuned in to what resources are available for our teens, but I know there are resources out there. And a lot of people have been making really, really good use of telehealth and getting their behavioral health needs met and getting just the kind of support that people need. One of the things that I and a lot of other members of the House of Representatives have been concerned about is as we're doing stay-at-home advisories, there are folks who are experiencing domestic violence or are with families that may not be as affirming or supportive. And that is of huge concern to a lot of us. So if you are experiencing any violence in the home, there are resources that you can reach out to. You can certainly email me and reach out to me online at social media, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. I'm on all of them. Tami Gouveia, MA is my handle for all three of those social media sites, and you can email me at tami.gouveia, and spelled G-O-U-V-E-I-A. My first name is T-A-M-I, and it's so it's tami.gouveia@mahouse.gov. So please reach out. there are so many people here to support you through this crisis and through any other crisis that you may be experiencing.
Thank you to all my guests for being on my first Pride episode of Charlie's Quarantine Corner. To join me for my virtual open mic, please go to rainbowchelmsford.org. And now, a presentation from this past weekend's performance.
Guys, can you be quiet? I'm trying to record my audio for my show.
Hello, it's me. I was wondering how you're holding up in quarantine to go over everything that the CDC says about social distancing. Hello, can you hear me? I'm in my new home office. It is just a closet, can't you see? Work is harder for me. I've forgotten how to log into my Google Meet. There's such a distance between us. 6 feet feels like a mile. Hello in your living room.
Between us, 6 feet feels like